Thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for either by your head at this time. Lord, we thank you right now.
Thank you, Lord.
God, we thank you for sweet Jesus one day at a time.
One day.
Give me the strength, God, to live one day at a time.
Yes,
yesterday is gone.
Mm.
Yeah, it's gone. It's just like wasting milk.
Yes,
it's gone. It can't be retrieved.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Yes,
but Holy Spirit, have your way today.
Yes,
move in our midst on today, God. We will bind every spirit that not like you, Lord.
Yes,
in the name of
Jesus.
And we send it back to the pits of hell.
Yes,
with all my seed from which it comes, God. It comes to steal, kill, and destroy.
Yes, yes, yes.
But you came, Jesus, that you may have life. And have it more abundantly. And that's what we will have. We will have life. We will have peace. We will have joy. In the name of Jesus. And we thank you, Lord. I thank you right now. Send your word. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
I thank God for being here. First, I thank God, just honor God for being God. I thank God for just being God. And I thank God for Pastor.
Amen.
Thank God for Pastor Cooper.
I was in prayer about the band once and I would just kept saying baby said this and baby said that and the lady of the house in there she stopped me. She said, now who is baby?
I said, my husband. I'm so sorry. It's my husband. That's what I told him. And baby is my husband. So I thank and I praise God for being here. You know, I came here because we wasn't having church at Rehoboth. And then after coming here, I said, I got to find a place. I said, I got to go. It was some places in Griffin. Some young preachers came from under Dead Page. They was there in Griffin, and I prayed, and I said, Lord, I got to go somewhere,
because
now they are lifting, and they said we can go back to church. And I said, and the scripture said, forsake not to assemble yourself together. And I said, I haven't got comfortable at home. I love it. I read, I study. I look at TBN, I kept my music on, I knew how to feed myself.
Yeah.
But when I first got saved, wasn't nobody saving Milner but me, or my mom and I, and I was the only youngest person in the church. So I knew how to feed my mind, I knew how to feed myself.
Yeah.
So when I couldn't get to church, I would play music.
Mm-hmm.
I would listen to that Mighty Mouth, Charlie Caesar. Jane Cleveland,
and the man from
Chicago, that man could talk,
Clay Irving.
And I said, oh God, I knew how to feed myself. And I stayed saved until Sunday, you know, when Ella Jenner would come down. Then he turned it over to Ella Rowland. So I said, God, I got to go somewhere. And the Lord, the Holy Spirit said, go where Harold Jr., Pastor Harold Jr., Visit Pastor Harold. So I came up and we visit, and he preaching like his granddaddy, and acting like his granddaddy, and moving like his granddaddy. And I said, oh my God. I said, now I love this, you know. And I believe that he tried to live right. You know, ain't nobody perfect. But you can what? You can, mom. Mother patients that strive to live right.
Yeah.
Some people not striving.
Right.
They get up and go right back. And they turn the corner and go right back to the corner. Some people, you got to learn how to turn your back on sin and go the other way. Ella Cooper, you said, then you converted. And that your sin may be what? When you converted, you turn. And if you turn away from something, you don't go back to it. You don't go back to it. Y'all got to help me. Because I haven't been up here in a while.
Okay.
I'm trying to do it, Pastor Cooper, decent and order.
Good.
trying to do, but I told the Holy Ghost, I said, I don't know which way you're going to take me. I said, but our subject today is talking about, and then I came to Pastor Cooper, and I'm going to finish this. And then I enjoyed what I heard, and I enjoyed what I see. And I thank God I'm here, like my husband said, to be an access, not a liability. I said, everywhere, I thought, sister, I said, and I didn't think about it when we turned here. And it dawned on me till 2 weeks later. Because I'm not caught up in organization. I'm caught up in living right. Come on, and living right. And living right. Oh, and Ella Cooper said, Elder John Cooper said, the devil can shout, he can preach, he can pray, he can do all of that, but he can't live right. And I find that out down through the year. And so I'm not caught up in organization, and I didn't think about it, Pastor Cooper, until about 2 or 3 weeks later after I returned. I said, Lord, I'm not coaching no more. Knowledge, wisdom, and understanding.
Yes.
We're coming from Proverbs 4 and 7, and it reads as following 4 and 7. Yes. Wisdom is the principal thing.
Yes.
Therefore, get wisdom, and with all by getting, get understanding.
Yeah.
I-N-G, understanding. You may receive it. Get understanding. That's where we are coming from. Get understanding. The word Proverbs comes from a Hebrew word that means to rule or to govern. And the purpose of Proverbs, the reason it was written, whichever, is to teach people how to attain wisdom, discipline, and a prudent life, which means a wise life, and how to do what is right, just, and fair, and to supply divine wisdom to our daily life. If you read Proverbs, you will think you're living in today's time. I mean, because it talk about everything I see on the news.
That's right.
People killing, gangs members, talking about getting together, killing someone on the way to school, robbing this girl, taking their life, and taking their money. All of that in Proverbs. It's not the dead face used to say that nothing new under the sun.
Right. book.
You're going to hear me call Dad Page's name sometimes. Yeah. Yeah. Mother Page's name.
That's right.
Yeah. Ain't your name.
That's right.
Oh,
that's
Bishop Cooper name.
That's right.
Yeah. Proverbs cover a wide range of topics,
mm-hmm.
including youth
mm-hmm.
and discipline.
Mm-hmm.
Family life,
mm-hmm.
self-control,
oh,
and a lot of that we don't have in and out of the church.
Mm-hmm.
Self-control.
Yeah.
Self-control. I may talk a little on a little things there. Self-control.
Mm-hmm.
I read one scripture that said, a fool is known by the multitude of the words.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
They talk too much.
Yeah.
They talk.
Uh-huh.
They know about every subject.
Yeah.
They talk about.
Yeah.
They professional in everything.
Yeah.
I don't care what you do, they know more than you.
Yeah.
I don't care what you say, they know how to do it. And they know, I know that. And, Pastor Cooper, you ought to do it like this. And they just no self-control. I think I'm getting a little ahead of myself. Self-control, your mouth.
Yeah.
Somebody said you have diarrhea at the mouth.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
some people does.
Yeah.
I don't like too much talking.
Yeah.
I don't do too much talking.
Yeah.
It, the Bible says, be slow to what?
Speak.
And
quick to hear.
Slow
to speak mm-hmm. and quick to hear.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what we're supposed to be.
Yep.
Yeah, we're not supposed to speak real quick.
Yep.
You think about what you're about to say.
Yep.
Yeah.
All right. Then it went on to say, resisting temptation.
Mm-hmm.
Proverbs talk on that.
Mm-hmm.
Because he talk about the woman on the street coming.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that wait for y'all men to come by.
That's right.
And we're talking about the woman in the church too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's in the church.
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
Resisting temptation.
That's right.
Proverbs talk about that.
That's right.
And the woman, he told me about a story in Proverbs. Said, the woman said, my husband gone off.
Long journey.
He on a long journey.
Yeah.
He won't be back to Friday.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you can come on over, John.
All week.
We got a whole week.
Yeah.
Wow.
It says she done sprayed the bed down.
Mm.
It says got a perfume real good.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and she cutting out on her husband.
Isn't that something?
You fool. And he working hard for you.
Yeah.
Give you anything that you desire.
Isn't that something?
That wife working hard.
Yeah.
Buying you suits.
Yeah.
And choose the match.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. And then you're gonna go to this woman just for a season. Just for a time of pleasure.
Pleasure.
That only lasts for a season.
Yeah.
And when you got a wife and a husband that take care of you. Oh, resisting temptation. It's bad these days.
Yes, it is.
It used to be bad on the street, but it's in the building.
Yes, it is.
When I say in the building, it's in the church.
That's right.
In the church.
That's right.
Ella John Cooper used to say you need a bag like a corn broom bag.
Yeah.
You don't know. Years ago, our brooms used to have wood.
That's right.
Wooden hammer.
Yeah,
it, you couldn't bend it.
No, you couldn't.
It was a wooden hammer.
Yeah.
Oh, something wrong with you, men. Every time you see a short dress, you better go back. You need to ask God, help me, God.
Yeah,
because it's supposed to move you too. Because why? You were made for woman, and woman were made for man.
Yeah.
But Ella Jones Cooper said, if it bothers you, turn your head.
Yeah.
Turn your head.
That's right.
Turn your head. If it bothers you, turn your head. Because you want to stay what? Safe.
That's right.
If it bothers you, if it coming down the eye, go down the other eye.
That's right.
If it coming down the middle eye, go through the same to the fellowship hall. Resisting temptation. Oh, Proverbs talk about all that little stuff.
Does.
It does. It talk about
yes, it. Does.
Business matter.
Yes, it does. Come on now.
Words and the tongues. Words and the tongues.
Mm-hmm.
My dad and one preacher came to our house and from Milner Church and And he came down, my father was there, and Mr. West this, and Mr. West that, and Mr. West this. And my daddy didn't say much. He just looked at me.
That's him.
Mr. West this, and Mr. West that, and Mr. West this. And then my when he left, my daddy said, he lies. I said, why'd you say that, Dad? He said, because he talks too much. And anybody that talk a lot somewhere, they lie. And that's what he said. He said, because he talks too much. And I didn't tell him, well, you're right. Because I go to church with my nose. Not reliable. You can't depend on me. So I didn't say nothing. You know, I said, oh, okay, Daddy. So Proverbs talk about marriage.
Yes, it
all right, it's an honor to marriage.
Yes,
to marry, the Bible says. Yes, it's honorable. Yeah. And the bed is undefiled.
Yeah.
It is seek, it Proverbs seek the truth,
mm-hmm.
wealth, and poverty. And of course, Proverbs talk about wisdom.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Now, Proverbs, our scripture read today said, wisdom is the principal thing.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
Which is the main thing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And we're talking about spiritual wisdom today.
Yeah. Come on now.
A lot of us got a natural wisdom.
Uh-huh.
And natural knowledge, you know, we know.
Yeah.
We know that computer. We know how to up and down, back and forth, take it apart, put it together. Yeah, we know that.
Yep.
All right, but he said we're talking about godly wisdom today.
Yes, yes, yes.
Godly wisdom.
Yes.
Somebody you like understanding.
Mm-hmm.
When you commit adultery in front of catching, you like understanding.
You lack it.
Yeah.
You lack it.
What part of thou shalt not commit adultery you don't understand? My baby and I, we use that word around the house. What part of whatever we're talking about you don't understand?
That's right. Yeah. All the time.
What part you don't understand?
Yeah.
What is so hard about thou shalt not lie?
Yeah.
What part of lying you don't understand?
Yeah.
Is the Easter egg lying?
Uh-uh.
The 7 o'clock lie?
Oh,
yeah.
What part of white lies,
oh,
black
Jesus.
Lies
yeah.
you don't understand?
Yeah.
Cause all liars gonna have their part in the lake of fire.
Yeah.
According to Revelation. What part of lying you don't understand?
Yeah.
I like that.
Okay, we want to get understanding today.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yes,
then it went on to say, Proverbs said, wisdom is the very most important part of our everyday living.
Everyday
living.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Then it said, I'm going to read a little something.
Okay.
Here. It said, knowledge. Okay, let me read this next scripture because I like Proverbs 1:7 also.
1:7.
We're going to be skipping around.
Okay, Proverbs
1:7. Proverbs 1:7 says, the fear of the Lord
is
the beginning of knowledge. Start kindergarten.
Yeah.
You don't lift over, you don't walk over Head Start.
Uh-huh.
The wisdom, the beginning of wisdom, the beginning of knowledge. And the beginning of, the fear of the Lord. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge.
The beginning.
Where you get your understanding, where you get your wisdom, is from God.
Yeah.
When I say fear of God, I mean don't mean, I'm scared. No.
Yeah.
I mean reverence.
Yeah.
There you go.
Reverence God.
Yeah.
Honor God.
Yeah.
Love on God.
Yeah.
Oh, when my baby and I were, I don't like to use the word dating because we didn't date like the world did.
Yeah.
But when we were seeing each other, he would write me letters.
Yeah.
And every now and then, I kept those letters. I got some now. They old and some about faded out. But I would read those letters.
Yeah.
We need to read God's word.
Come on.
Like my mom said.
Come on.
If we love him.
Yeah.
We need to read his word.
Yeah.
That's where we're going to get knowledge.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yep. That's right.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, but fools.
Uh-huh.
I didn't call you a fool.
Scripture's
in the book.
The scripture says.
Yeah.
But fools despise wisdom and instruction out of the word of God. It gives you wisdom. It gives you instruction.
Yes. Beautiful, beautiful.
That's the word of God. Give you wisdom. It teaches you to marry that woman. Oh, be subject to your wife.
Yeah.
Wives, you be subject to your husband.
Yeah.
Obey your husband.
Yeah.
In all things, right things.
That's it.
Yeah. In all right things.
Yeah. Right things.
The things of the Lord.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay? And then it said, knowledge is the information you have learned.
Uh-huh.
And then Roland Cooper said, you can't testify, you can't witness if you don't have no word.
Yes.
So we got to get some information in us.
Yes.
And how we get the information is through this word.
Yes.
How we get the information is through this word.
Right.
We should live, how we should walk, is in the word.
Right.
I don't have a been to walking crooked.
Mm.
When the word tell me to walk upright.
Right.
Walk upright.
Yes,
and speak the truth in my heart.
Yeah.
I have no business slipping out on Ella when the word tell me to love my husband. Cling to my husband.
Yes,
yes, yes, yes. We got to get some knowledge. Now, you know that book knowledge.
Uh-huh.
You got that computer knowledge.
Yes.
But we need to get some word.
Come on,
Jesus,
word.
Then it went on to say, you have learned, okay? Knowledge is the information you have learned.
Uh-huh.
While wisdom is the ability to use that knowledge.
Oh, I see that.
Wisdom is the ability to use that knowledge. Some people got knowledge and they don't know what to do.
Yeah.
They so too small, they just dumb.
Yeah.
They don't know what to do. Yeah, but wisdom tells you what to do with that knowledge.
Yes.
Hey, God will tell you.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then it went on to say, in a profound way.
Yeah.
So knowledge is a part and wisdom is the whole.
Yeah.
Oh, knowledge is a part, but wisdom is the whole. I thank God. I have a cousin, I love her so much, and I love them all. And but one cousin I know, she going to school. I said, have you finished college yet? She said, no, I got this year, I got that. You know, I got one more year. Next year, I think I finish up. I said, oh, okay then. Seems like she been going to college a long time. And then, but she loves God, but she got knowledge. This book knowledge here, this Bible knowledge. She loves God.
Yes,
she got worldly knowledge and she got godly knowledge.
Yes.
And she got the wisdom to go along with it.
Yes.
Wisdom go along beyond your learning factors and include making sense. Some people don't have, they don't make sense.
Yeah.
Why you make $3,000 a month, a week, and you don't have $50 for gas the next week?
Something
don't make sense.
Something
don't make sense. Proverbs talk about that too.
Right.
He talk about the ant.
Yeah.
That little ant, you can say what you want to say, but watch that little ant.
Yeah.
I live in the country, and we call those little ant houses, we call them ant beds.
Uh-huh.
In the summertime, he busy working.
Yeah.
He crawling.
Yeah.
All on your refrigerator. Your countertop.
That's right.
And you don't want you to be in your bed. Anyway, he can find a crumb.
Yeah.
But he busy stacking up for the wintertime.
Right.
Take a lesson from the ant.
Yes, sir.
You're not going to be 50 and 30 and 40 all your life.
No.
Wintertime coming in the 6th and
7th. Oh, yeah.
Right. And you're going to have to stack up something somewhere. You're not going to be able to drive a truck.
Yeah.
500,000 miles at 72.
I'm telling you.
Get some wisdom from the head.
Yeah.
Stack something back.
Yes,
yeah. Oh, stack something back. Oh, Proverbs talk about all of that.
Yeah.
Slothfulness.
Uh-huh.
Lazy.
Yeah.
How
Yeah, you own it.
You got to work to have something. My daddy told me ain't nobody gonna give you nothing. Yeah. He told me, he said, you work for whatever you
go
want.
Get it.
Hallelujah. You gonna work for whatever you want. You want your hair done? You want that $300 wig? Go to work. Hey. You want that new car? Go to work. That's what happened when the government just about to fall some people.
Don't say that.
Hand me down. No, get up and go to work.
That's right.
You got book knowledge. Mm. Put it to work.
Yes, sir. Yes.
You know what to do and how to do on that computer. Yes. Put it to work.
Yes.
You know how to tear it down. Put it together. Yes. Put it to work.
Yes.
Don't be slow for them.
Jesus.
Don't be hollering about, I'm going to wait till I get married. And honey, I'm going to be, he's going to get me a house. And he's going to get it yourself.
Jesus.
I told my niece, don't be dependent on no man.
Yes,
depend on God.
Yes,
hey, did you want you a car? Go to work.
Yes,
oh, and every one of them is a worker now.
Yes,
all my nieces
yes,
work.
Right. Yes,
they work yes, and they right. buy that new car. You buy your home.
That's right.
You go to work.
Go to work.
So when they said what you got to bring to the table,
uh-huh. yep.
you let them know you sitting at my table.
Come on now. Yes, sir.
What you gonna bring to the table? You,
don't
do that word. But you sitting at my table.
Yes, sir.
Matter of fact, let me bring it to your attention. You under my roof. Hey!
Go to work.
Wilson, go to work. Lady, take care of yourself.
Yeah.
Oh, my daddy said, I done took you to school. I done sent you to school. If you want to go to college, I'll pay for that.
Right. Yes, you would.
But he said, you got a place to stay. But buying your clothes, you can eat, you're going to have to go to work.
Yeah.
He said, he let me know, you got to go to work.
Yeah.
If you're not going to school, you got to go to work. You got to go to work. You got to slow and laying around. Sleeping to 1 and 2 o'clock in the evening. No, get out from there.
Yeah.
Take your intelligent self to work. Knowledge of myself for work.
Yes,
we in the book.
Yes,
we in the book.
Yes, in the
I'm going all the way. God, the Holy Spirit, you're taking me everywhere.
Yes,
go to work.
Flow,
go to work. Go to work. Go to work. Go to work. Then it said, go to work.
Mm-hmm.
And you need to go to work. Mm-hmm. Okay? We're going
to
go on, y'all.
Uh-huh.
Psalms 111:10 said, the A part of that scripture said, the beginning of true wisdom is when you fear God.
Mm-hmm.
That's the beginning of true wisdom.
True wisdom.
You don't have real, you say you got some wisdom, but the true wisdom,
mm-hmm.
I'm going to say, they're going to take you from day to day living.
Come on, day to day.
True wisdom. They're going to help you pass that woman on the street corner or that man that's trying to get you true wisdom. True wisdom. Going to help you get up and don't be slothful and go to work. Put in your application here, one now and one over here. True wisdom. Okay? Job 28:28 said unto man, he said, behold, the fear of the Lord. That is wisdom.
Mm.
And to depart from evil is understanding.
Yeah.
And to depart from evil. What part of evil you don't understand? What part of evil we don't understand? Oh, in Galatians, it lists a lot of them. Five. What part of evil we don't understand?
Mm.
Depart from evil.
Depart from it.
We want God to do this and we want God to do that. And God is telling us to depart. evil.
That's it.
Depart from evil. And when you depart from something, you get away from.
Stay away from.
You turn away from. You close it out. You get away from it. Okay? And then if you don't know what to do and how to do, James 1 and 5 said, if any man lack your wisdom about what to do or how you should do this, let him answer God that give to all men liberally, freely, and uprightly, not and shall be given to what? Him. All right? We give it to him. Okay, I'm about to. I'm like Pastor Cooper, this number one. About to wind it up. We're going to talk about at least two persons that I think use this wisdom.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay.
That two persons that I think it was more that use knowledge.
Okay.
Yeah. And understanding.
Okay.
So we're going to go to Genesis 39. When in your time, read 1 through 23. But we're going to just read the ninth verse. Joseph. Joseph.
Yeah.
You know Joseph with the men, the coat with men colors.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
You know Joseph, you know the one that brothers hated him. Because his father saw him, show him a little more favor. You got to watch that. That's another lesson.
Yep.
But he was the one with the many colors.
Yeah.
And the brother that hated him.
Yeah.
You know Joseph?
Yeah.
That they put in the ditch.
Yeah.
And then they sold him out.
Mm-hmm.
And then they took him to Egypt.
Mm-hmm.
And then Potiphar hide.
Yep.
Can I tell it like I
come on now?
Can I tell it like I said?
Come on.
Okay. And you read the story.
Yeah.
Okay. And he was doing good.
That's right.
Potiphar seen favor in Joseph, made him overseer of his house.
Look at that.
Oh, overseer of the house.
Yeah.
Made him chairman deacon of the chairman. Oh, cool. Joseph minding his own business.
That's it.
Taking care of his business in the house.
Yeah.
In the house.
Going about his daily duties in the house.
That's right.
And hearing this old ungodly, unrighteous wife. Seeing Joseph looking good, handsome. Dark complexion.
And
he was a Hebrew with a dark brown, dark black hair.
Yeah.
Tall and looking good.
Yeah.
She forgot about Potiphar. She forgot about Potiphar. She forgot she was married.
Yes, sir.
Then Joseph going about doing his daily business. She every time he would go to the to Potiphar's wife room to do what he's supposed to do in there, she hollered, Joseph.
Oh, Jesus.
Joseph.
Hide the
picture. Oh, Jesus.
Hide the picture.
Oh, you're so handsome, Joseph. Yeah. Oh, your dark black hair, Joseph.
Yeah.
Your caller said, your apps.
Yeah.
He said, I got some apps. I said, okay. Apps. And your muscles. And where you been lifting weight, Joseph. If you just stop a little bit, Joseph. Let us talk. Joseph kept doing his business. Going about what he's supposed to do.
That's right.
And every day he go in there, that she come.
Oh, Jesus.
There come the devil. On your job, there come the devil. No, you can just about, I don't know why the Holy Spirit did me like this, but you can just about tell when your husband been through something on your job when he comes to one of those powerful women.
Yeah.
I just about tell.
Yeah.
I said, oh God, help him on that job.
Yeah.
Deliver him on that job.
Yeah.
Powerful, and Joseph, powerful gone now. Till one day she went in there to do her, and Joseph went in there to do his duty. She said she gonna force herself on you.
Yeah.
That's what it was.
Yeah.
She gonna force herself on you. She Joseph. She counted him.
Oh,
he couldn't get by.
Oh.
Joseph, you go lay with me today. Mm-hmm. Joseph, you gonna do something today. You're not getting out of here, Joseph, until you do something.
Oh, yes, she did.
Oh, but Joseph seen that get away under the arm. So Joseph stood down and Joseph got away under the arm.
Left
she reached for the jacket.
Left
and Joseph left it in her hand. Yeah. We need more Joseph today.
Yes, sir.
Hey. We need more Joseph today. Hey. Run from that house. Run from that prostitute.
Yeah.
We need more Joseph today. Run from that church hole. Wanna stay alive and you wanna live, you better run. Yeah. All she has to do is kill you, and you another buckle on her belt. That's all. Joseph said, "There is none greater in the in my master's house.
Yeah.
I neither have he kept back from me." Joseph was talking to her.
Yeah.
Say it's not greater in my father's house than my master's house.
Yeah.
He kept you back from me. Cause why? Cause you are his wife.
Yeah.
Joseph said, "How can?" And he said, "And because he said he had kept nothing else back from me but you." He said, "Because thou art his wife."
Yeah.
Joseph said, "Joseph got understanding." How can I do this great thing? He didn't say a little bitty thing.
Great
thing. He said, "How can I do this great
thing?
How can I do it? This great, but great and wicked sin against God. Not also, you're not sinning against just powerful. I will be sinning also against God." When I do this great thing, I won't be only sinning against Anthony, but I'll be sinning against God. I'll be sinning against God. Yeah. And Dad Page said he got a big a video thing, and we think we can get everything on this YouTube and everything. No, your stream not like God's. And he got this big old stream, and he gonna show us when we stand before him. When you didn't run from that woman, you didn't run from that man, but you stayed there. Okay, I'm about to wind it up. And then he said, "How can I do this great thing before for him, before my master?" He done gave me everything. He left me in charge of everything. And you know what the devil do? He allowing you. She allowing you. After he left the coat in his, after he left his coat in her hand, she told Potiphar, "Look, see, look,
evidence."
Got evidence.
Yeah.
And you let that Hebrew come in our house.
Look at that.
You gave him authority over everything. Now look what he have done to you. See? He forced himself on me. You liar.
Liar.
Yeah. You liar. And they allow on you.
Yeah.
They allow on you. Cause they want to break you down.
Yeah.
They want to bring you down to nothing.
Yeah.
So they allow on you.
Right.
So you better run.
Yeah.
Leave the coat.
Yeah.
That's one I think that has wisdom and understanding.
You got that.
Knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. Okay, we're going to go to King Solomon.
Yes.
Okay, in your time, just read 1 Kings 3:16 to 28. But I'm going to be reading 2 Chronicles 1 and 10. Solomon became the king of Israel after David left. And David passed on, and Solomon was his son, so he became king of Israel.
That's right.
Yeah, he asked, God asked Solomon, Solomon, what do you want me to give you? Because God could give you anything.
Yes, he can.
But Solomon said, give me now wisdom. 2 Chronicles 1 and 10. And knowledge. Yeah. Look at Solomon. That I may go out and come in.
Yes.
Oh, I used to wonder, what do that mean?
Yeah.
I heard a preacher explain it the other day. That I may go out and come in.
Yes.
Before this people, which is Israel.
Yes.
For whom can judge thy people that is so great?
Yeah.
Give me wisdom.
Wisdom.
God, give me wisdom on how to operate this ministry.
That's right.
Give me wisdom and how to relate to my husband.
Yeah.
Give me wisdom on how to relate to my wife.
Yeah.
Give me wisdom because this child seems to be getting out of control.
Yeah.
And I have done all I can do.
Yeah.
Now, God, you got to give me some wisdom.
Yeah.
So God gave Solomon some wisdom.
Yes.
And the word said he was the wisest king that ever lived.
Yes,
and the richest king that ever lived.
Wow.
And it won't be no
won't
more.
Be another one.
It ain't going to be another one
like
Solomon.
Yeah.
Solomon. Now in 2 Kings, it's going to tell you, in 1 Kings, it's going to tell you how he used this wisdom.
Because
there were two hollow that lived together.
Yes,
oh yeah.
Hey, two hollows live together.
Yeah.
And they that's what the Bible calls them.
Yeah.
Two of they lived together.
Yeah.
And they got pregnant about the same time.
Jesus.
Both of them had babies.
Yeah.
Both of them had babies. Nobody else lived in the house but them.
Uh-huh.
But just those two.
Mm-hmm.
And they had babies.
Uh-huh.
One hollow, one lady, one woman. As she was sleeping, she rolled over on her baby and suffocated her baby.
She did.
During the night, she switched babies.
Yes, she did.
She switched babies. Read the book.
See,
it's so much knowledge.
Yes, she did.
It's so much
in the Bible.
In the Bible.
Uh-huh.
Oh, it's so many good love stories.
Yes, it is.
Oh, it's so wonderful. I didn't know it was in there until I started reading it.
Yeah.
Read the book.
Look at this. And then they took the baby sheep, and then the lady with the head that woke up and the baby was dead, she went to nurse the baby and the baby was dead. And she said, and then you know she kept looking at the baby, and as time went on that day, she realized this is not my baby.
You know your baby.
And so she confronted the other lady.
That's right.
The sister that was living with her. Can I just call her?
No.
Sister girl that was living with her. She said, Sister girl. I think you got my baby. Sister girl said, no, I don't have your baby.
No.
This is my baby.
Uh-huh.
She said, no, sister girl, come. I know my baby.
A mother know
her baby.
Yeah.
Oh, in some place on that body or somewhere in that face, she know her baby. She said, sister girl, I think you got my baby. She said, I know, I don't have your baby. She said, well, I tell you what we're going to do. We're going to go to the king.
Yeah.
And Solomon was the king at that time.
Right.
So they took both babies to Solomon. And so the mother said, that's my baby. Sister girl said that, no, it's my baby. The mother said, no, it's my baby, king, because I know this is my baby, because he got this little dimple right here. And then right behind the neck is a little skull right here, a little birthmark. So I know my baby. Sister girl said, no, it's my baby, king. One living baby, the other dead.
Yes.
Bring the baby here.
That's right.
So they brought the baby to King Solomon.
Mm-hmm.
King Solomon laid the baby down. King Solomon, look at wisdom.
Yeah, yeah.
That's
mercy.
Yeah, that's God. Yeah.
You know why he had that wisdom? Because he know how to go out. And he know how to come in.
Yeah.
When he went out, he said, teach me, God, how to go out before your people. Teach me how to come in when I come into your house. He know how to lay before God. He know how to come in and lay before God. He knew how to come in and get a prayer through from God. He knew how to come in and talk to God.
Yeah.
He knew how to come in and get instruction from God.
Right.
Solomon knew how. He said, teach me to do like my father David did.
Because
David knew how. He came in from the battlefield, but he went into God before he went back out. That's the reason we're able to win so many wars. That's the reason we were able to win so many battles. Because we know how to come in. So when he went out, he was full of lonely. Hey, he know how. So Solomon said, I want to know how to do that. I want to know how to pray like Jack and May prayed.
Yeah.
I want to know how to pray like Joanne prayed.
Yeah.
I'm on my seat. I want to know how to pray like Betty Ann prayed.
Yeah.
I may not sound like her, but I want to be able to get out some.
Yeah.
Hey. When I pray,
yeah.
I may not sound like her.
Yeah.
You may not hear nothing coming out, out of my mouth like hello. But you know I can get a prayer through. Because I get an answer from God. Hey! So Solomon wanted to know, Lord, I want to know how to do that. So God granted him that. And he said, because you didn't ask for that, the riches and the wealth and your enemy and all of that other stuff, I'm just going to put a little extra on that. I'm going to give you that. I'm going to give you that. Yes, Lord, I'm going to give you that. So they brought the baby. They laid the baby before the king. And the king, Solomon, waiting on God. See, you got to wait on God. So God said, the soldier to bring you a sword.
Right. Oh my God.
So he had the soldier bring me a sword.
Yeah.
When he brought the sword, he said, okay. Yeah. What Solomon was going to do is divide the baby.
Cut it up.
Ain't no baby no good to nobody desire to
die. Right.
Ain't no, you divide that baby. She ain't no good.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
No good. He drew back the sword.
Yeah.
And begin to come down, and the mother says, stop.
Yes.
Give her the baby.
Yep.
The mother, a real mother, going to cry out, stop. Give her the baby. She can have the baby.
Look at
that. Give her the baby.
Yes.
And Solomon said, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Took the baby up and gave it to the real mother.
Yes.
He said, you are the mother.
Yes.
Because you stopped me.
Yes.
And gave and prevented the death of the baby.
Yeah.
Now, so if that ain't your baby, you don't care what's gonna happen.
That's
to
right.
You. And that's how sister girl worked. She didn't care what happened.
That's right.
To the baby. Because why? It wasn't her baby.
That's right.
It wasn't her baby. So I thank God. That's all I have for you all today. Amen. Thank God for the word of God. And I hope someone that.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.